open jaw. If you will do this way, sometime it may jump and sometime you may lose it anywhere in the omentum loop. And once it is trapped into the omentum loops, then it is sometime you have to bring the C arm and sometime you may have to do laparotomy if the needle is completely trapped or lost. So you should avoid missing the needle inside the abdomen. Now we will see how to tie the different type of surgeon's knot. First we will see how to align the needle. If you want to align the needle, then drop the needle in such a way that tip should be towards your left and the tail should be towards your right. And then you go with the partially open jaw. This is partially open jaw. Bring the upper jaw above, lower jaw down and press by the upper jaw. And then automatically it will get aligned and it is ready to take the bite. So remember that this is a very important trick, how to hold it. I believe that all of you are trained in those situations. It is not a problem. And then you have to tie the knot. I will just demonstrate to you how to tie the surgeon's knot. Surgeon's knot, this is just over the tissue. The pictures have been taken on the simple tissue to demonstrate to you. Here we can see, this is surgeon's knot. Just press it, hold it, and then take a bite. This is the bite taken. Once you have taken a bite, then guard it and pull it. After that, now make a C. This is a C. And then this is a nice C. Remember that the left hand instrument should be in the center of the C. And right hand instrument has to rotate little bit and take the wine. Remember how to take the wine. This way you have to rotate. And then go and catch it and don't pull the tail. Keep the tail loose there only and slide the long limb. And this is the first hitch taken. After first hitch, now you can make a reverse C. C should not, this is C. C is wrong. You have to reverse C. This way, this is reverse C. Why? To avoid reef knotting. To avoid reef knotting. And this is the another wind taken. And don't pull the tail again. Keep it loose. And slide the long limb. And this is the second wind taken. Again, you bring it here. And just you get it like this. And slowly you will take it. And this is the last taken. And this way surgeon's knot can be tightened very nicely with the help of simple you can perform. And got it here, catch it, and now you cut the seizure with the seizures. 1 centimeter should be left. And this way surgeon's knot can be easily tightened. So remember, first time 2 wrap followed by single opposite alternating wrap. So first C, then reverse C, and again C. And that way surgeon's knot can be tightened. Again, this is the just the second one. You can see how the suture has to be, needle has to be aligned. This is the bite taken. And then hold by the left hand. And then leave the right. And before pulling it, guard it. Guard it. Why guarding is necessary? On this tissue, guarding was not necessary. But your practice should be perfect, because if you are suturing over the bowel or tube, if you will not guard it, it will be dragged from one side to another side, isn't it? And then this is guarded, and then again you make the limb 2 centimeters, and then this is a C. Keep the left hand in the center of the C, and this is a 2 wrap taken, and then catch the tail, tip of the tail end, and this is tightened. Soulasse should be avoided. This is soulasse. Soulasse means if your tail is big, then sometime you will get like this soulasse. So this should be avoided, because it will make your knot loose and this should be out. Here we can see another knot is also there, that should be avoided. And when you are tightening, it should be tightened on the same plane, same tissue plane. And then make a reverse C. This is reverse C, and then this is the second knot taken. And if suture here is little small, and then go get the tail and then slide it, and this is the second knot taken. And now the final knot. So in the surgeon's knot, this way you will tie. And for the final knot, again you make a C. How to make a C? Just you catch the suture near. Here this is a square only. for surgeon, one C also should be there. And this way, surgeon's knot can be tightened. Now, the next knot is tumble square knot. Tumble square knot is also a very good knot, easy knot, and it can be tightened with the help of, again, endoscopic needle. And just you go at the junction of 2/3 and 1/3, press it, and it is aligned. Remember that it should not be backward angulated. This is backward angulated. If it is backward angulated, then press by the tail and it will get corrected. If it is backward angulated, it should be corrected. And this is a bite taken. Again, you hold it same way, catch it, take it out, and another tissue. This is basically used for the tough tissue, like for approximation of the myometrium in the myoma, or for fundoplication, or for, you can see, the birth suspension. So this is where you have, or for some time for the hernia ring approximation. And now you should take one wind only, and then this is the first part of the knot. Remember, in tumble square knot, first hitch should never be tightened. It should just be nearer the tissue. And then you take a reverse sieve, and then make the another part of a square knot. This is basically a square knot. And you will make it tumbled. Tumble means making it straight. This is a square knot. Now if you will see this thread, and this thread is same thread, and this tail end and this side, right side, is same. Most of the time, when you are taking the bite from the needle, needle end and right side will be same. So you make it straight. Just you hold it here and then catch it there, and both you will make straight. This is straight end. And then slowly you can push it with the help of the knot pusher. And nicely you can see it has approximated. And this is known as buttock sign. Buttock sign means just like the buttock in the prone position. And it is the idea that the tension was given and tissue is approximated. And then it is untumbling. Untumbling means just pull the both the end again, and this is last locking. So you can lock it, and this way tumble square knot is tightened. And then again you can cut it with the help of scissors. So tumble square knot is very good knot, because unlike open surgery, here the index finger of the assistant is not sitting over your knot. And knot has always this potential risk of getting loose. So this way, the tumble square knot is helpful whenever you think that you will be in trouble. Again, the another tumble square knot here, it is just demonstrated. Then you can take a bite here, and this is your one end, and then take another. So even the tissue far apart, you can pull nearer to each other with the help of this knot. And this is the another bite taken. And you can see approximately 2 to 3 centimeter gap is there in between. But you can do it. Remember, the tail should be little bigger, at least 4 centimeter, for the tumble square knot. Because your knot is basically, initially, it is winded away from the tissue, loose. So this is the first part of the tumble square. Again you go, and this is the second part of the tumble square, and approximate it nearer to each other. Don't make it very tight, just approximate, and then catch the same side of the thread, and this is known as tumbling. After tumbling, it is ready to slip, and it is slept, and now it is pulling the structure. Then untumble. How to untumble? Just pull both the end, and again it is converted into a square knot. And then last, locking hitch. Locking hitch, you can take anything. You can take C, or you can take reverse C, both. Locking hitch can be C or reverse C, both. Any you can use. And this way, tumble square knot can be tightened. During the myoma or fundoplication, it is very important, because tissue is under tension. And you can pull the tensed tissue nearer to each other with the help of this knot. And again, it is cut. Now the next knot I will show you, that is the continuous suturing with the Aberdeen termination. That is Dundee jamming knot with the modified Dundee jamming knot. And this, how to make the Dundee jamming knot outside, you have seen already. And this way you can make a Dundee jamming knot and pull it there, and just get a bite here. This way you can take a bite, and then just you take it here and then you introduce your one instrument through this loop. This is the loop, and get the needle out. Just pull the needle out. थोड़ा सा एक नायलन फीड लेते आना तो डंडी जमिंग नॉट बताना है. And this way it is out, and then you can push it, and it is locked. Once it is locked first, then this is the starter knot. Basically, this is a starter knot, and it is started. And then always make a C, and then keep on taking the wind in between the C. I will just demonstrate you how to use it. So we will see here that how to use the dandy jamming. So this is, you can hold it. It is not necessary to have the finger, but you can do without that also. But I will show you here. Now you have to trap it like this, and then this is a loop. You have to pull it from above like this, and this is the dandy jamming knot ready. Again you go and again you pull it, loop within loop, it is ready. You can do without your assistant also. How? That you make a loop, put your finger inside, catch it and pull it. This is your first knot ready. Again you go inside, hold it and pull it. This is your second knot ready. So this way, this is the beauty of the starter knot. So you hold it this way, put your finger, get it here and pull it. This is your first wind. Again you go, you can pull it. It is just like a birding termination. There is no much difference. And beauty is that you can open it. It should not make any knot. It is just a loop. It is not a knot. So hold it, the shorter above the longer. Go inside, catch the loop and pull it. This is your first wind. Again you go and pull it. This is second wind. And this is knot ready. So the same way we have this. And then put the knot inside. Put with the needle inside. So we will see here, this is a dandy jamming knot, continuous suturing with the Aberdeen termination. So basically this knot has extracorporeally made, and then you will drop it intracorporeally, and then take a bite here. This is the bite taken, and then just you go through this and introduce your needle holder inside, catch it and pull it out. And after that, get the complete tail end out, needle out, and then it is locked. If you want to make it further tight, you can push by the open jaw of the Maryland and it is locked. And then you start continuous suturing. Although it is not necessary to start with the dandy jamming knot, you can start with the simple surgeon's knot, and then you can do also the continuous suturing. So, but basically it is used for peritoneum after hernia surgery. So tying the surgeon's knot on the roof is difficult, whereas dandy jamming knot, it will be easier. And then keep on taking the bite in between the loop. And this way this is taken. And every time keep on locking. Why every time locking is better? Because here you don't have the assistant, and you don't have the privilege of using the finger of the assistant. Or if you want, some surgeons, they use the one another port to keep that long limb kept pulled. But it is not necessary. If you will keep on locking every time, then without this also you can continue. And this way, this is the just like a blanket suture, just like a continuous suturing, you can keep on taking. It's a very nice knot, less time taking. Because if you will tie 3-4 surgeons knot, it will take a lot of time. But if you will do this way, it will be easier. And this way 2, 3, 4, how many, it completely up to you. You can keep on taking the winds. And this way this is continuous suturing is going. And slowly you can hold it. And keep on giving some lock. Means you should keep on securing it. How? You can keep the pulled one of the long thread. This knot is not very good for the bowel anastomosis, or for the structure where there is a lot of tension, because in those situations it may leak. So basically it is for peritoneum or for vault closure or just for serous layer of the myoma, once you have taken the muscular layer. And then we will see how to terminate. During termination you should not make a C. During termination, here this is the last, and after that we will see how to terminate. Termination is done by Aberdeen. So it is dandy jamming and Aberdeen. and it is 20 centimeters. So that's why some people they see that dandi jamming not was started in the dandi, and Aberdeen termination they have invented in the Aberdeen University, and the distance from the dandi to Aberdeen is 20 kilometers approximately, 20 miles, sorry. So that's why they are saying that it started from dandi and terminated at Aberdeen with the 20 centimeters of the suture. So you can go like that, and this is the termination. So go loop within the loop. This is one loop, and then it is tightened, and only non-needle end has to be pulled. And then first is only tightened. If first time it is loose, then all other knot will not be tight. So make it first not tightened. And then again you go inside the loop, pull it, but don't allow the needle to come out. Don't allow the needle to come out. Like this, and then don't allow the needle. If needle is coming out, just you leave the needle and pull the non-needle end. And needle should never come out. If needle will come out, it will open. It will be loose. And then it is second knot. And now the last time, take the needle out. And this way, now the last one, needle is coming out. And that way, now the dandi jamming knot is finished, and then you can cut it. So this is a continuous suturing, and any of these can be combined together. You can take the bite. This is one end of the bobble intratomy, and you can take another, and you can apply for bobble intratomy, perforated bobble. Always it is better to use the interrupted surgeon's knot. That is better, and because it will not make your stump that inverted. So it will approximate the layer nicely, and then you can take the winds. So this way, this is the tail. Here the suture is little small. If the suture length is smaller, then you can hold the needle also. But if the suture length is more than 12 centimeters, then needle holding is risky, because it may overshoot, especially when you are tightening the knot. So always remember that it is better to avoid holding the suture. Needle, always try to hold the suture. So this is the suture near the needle, and then this is the reverse C. And then you can take the wind and you can tie it. This way, this is the just a demonstration of the surgeon's knot over the tissue. And it is first time double wrap followed by single opposite alternative wrap. And you can make it tighter, and this is tightened. So this type of extracorporeal knot and intracorporeal knot, both can be used in the different situation. So some other knots are there that I can demonstrate to you in the cases of different situations. But these were the most common. Some are the western knot. Like I would like to demonstrate to you western knot. So we have to see one of the knot which is generally recommended by some of the gynecologists. So it is better to learn. This is western knot. So you hold it, go from one side to another, again from here to this, and again from down above, and again you take it. Can you see? This way western knot can be tightened. And then without the knot pusher, it can be slipped. So this is a video from Dr. Nutan Jain's book. Actually, she has given more preference for this knot. Although generally we don't use it much, but because already it was recommended in some of the other articles also. This is the other way, by twisting the hand. But that won't be very easy for you. It's better to do directly. And this way you can tie it. So again I will demonstrate you how to use that. This way you go, and always it is reverse from left side, again take a wind, again from right side take a reverse way. This way if you will keep on changing the hand, you can use the western knot, and it is tightened, right? And this is the first way, and it can slip without the knot pusher. This is the second way. Just by twisting the hand also, you can take it. This is the first. Again you go and turn it. And then you catch it. So this way it comes like that, and again you can put it in. The purpose of both the things are same. That basically it is a very simple knot and it will slip like that. And this is the same in the clinical practice. This is the Western knot going on. And you can hold it. And then you can just catch it there. And keep on pulling. And then it will go there. Keep on pulling it. It will go there. Slowly you will keep on giving the thrust. It will go there. So this is the Western knot. It's a very simple, very small thrust, and this way it can be pulled. Western knot is